Now, some of you might think they're tacky, others the height of exclusivity.
Takes all types. Whatever stance you take, you've got to admit, personalised plates, they can be memorable.
Sure can. But what do you do if the plate you thought was unique to you is actually shared with another? Caitlin investigates.
Who cares what your wheels say about you when you can tell the world your way? It's easy to see. Someone who's too late for work, a quick mum in Ponsonby, or a great nan in Rota Vegas. This driver wants to date you, maybe even marry.
Oh yes, even we couldn't make this stuff up. You really can spell things out with six characters or less. But what if the perfect combination that belongs to you also belongs to someone else at the same time? Is that even possible?
We're about to find out in Te Mātua Māui, Hawke's Bay, where we meet Nigel. He's more of a boat than car guy.
What a day, Nigel.
Stunning. Great day.
If only we could enjoy it on the water, but Nigel's been grounded because of a problem with the plate on his boat trailer.
I got a phone call out of the blue October last year from the police up in Auckland, suggesting that I have a number plate that's belonging to a complainant in Auckland.
He sent the paperwork to prove he owned it.
They never had any more.
So it was back to the lake to have fun on
our boat. Yeah, well, that's our boat. That's our baby. So yeah, it's our pride and joy.
And his friends knew it. That's why they bought the plate off Trade Me and gave it to Nigel as a parting gift.
There was lots of upset when they left and went back to the UK. We were like brothers, and yeah, it's quite special.
So he wasn't thrilled to get another call, this time from Waka Kotahi, the transport agency.
Asking for photos and what have you, information, suggesting that my number plate was a duplicate.
It seemed someone somewhere else owned a boat too.
I don't know how that could possibly be. There's no way you can have two vehicles with the same plates.
That's why there's paperwork, right? When someone sells a plate, they need to complete a transfer of entitlement form. If there's no record of that, then the buyer can fill out a statutory declaration that gets signed off by a justice of the peace and sent on to the official manufacturer. That's what Nigel did, and has a certificate of registration to show for it.
As far as I know, I'm all above board.
But Waka Kotahi said he had to give it up for a standard issue plate instead.
I don't see why I should have to hand it over.
Neither did the other plate owner. We've spoken to the man in Auckland who's revealed a boat has been in the family for 20 years. He's just as frustrated over the mix-up and says it's been painstaking, trying to prove the plate belongs to him alone.
So, could they both be right?
It turns out that back in 2004, so 17 years ago, the plate manufacturer made an error. They manufactured two of these plates, and both of those plates were provided to the original purchaser. And from there, two of them have ended up in circulation.
One stayed with family and friends, and the other was somehow sold years later. The Auckland boatie did have the plate first, but for a few months in 2018, after he sold his boat and before he bought a jet ski, his plate wasn't registered to a vehicle. In that short window, Nigel and Napier successfully registered his plate.
This is the only situation that we're aware of where something like this has happened.
Both men might be in the right, but they can't both have a boat on the road. Well, not exactly.
We've offered Nigel three different alternatives for very similar personalised plates, and we're really chuffed that he's found one that he likes, and he's accepted that offer.
Waka Kotahi says the other owner had a clear history with the plate combination, so gets to keep the exclusive rights, which means both boaties can now get back to their happy place.
Oh, that is a cool plate. Yeah. I'm really pleased they sorted that out. Turns out personalised plates can make a splash off the road too, especially if you come up with a clever combo. Right now, the plate Uber, that's with two U's, is listed on Trade Me for $75,000.
That is a lot of money for a spelling mistake. We'll let you know how it goes.
Yes, because it hasn't actually sold yet.